Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build two rather simple 2x2 pop-up block swappers for the floor and the ceiling. Now they are pretty simple. All you need to do is basically flick the lever and then this 2x2 patch of blocks that are one above the floor or one below the ceiling will get swapped out with a completely different set. You can use pretty much any kind of movable block, doesn't matter whether it's a full block or a transparent block for those. And obviously the ceiling works just the same way. So that's basically what I want to show you today. Now let's talk about the sizes. Now those are not the most compact possible designs, but they are rather simple to build and don't require too many resources. So let's talk about the sizes anyway. The height is, if you count the floor or the ceiling, 5 blocks. 6 blocks if you also count the area where the blocks extend into. Both designs are 6 blocks long and 10 blocks wide. So they basically have the same size since they are pretty much just mirror images, more or less. And with that, let's talk about the required resources. So to build them for the floor version, you're gonna need, of course, building blocks. Then 17 redstone dust, 1 redstone torch, 13 redstone repeaters, 13 observers, 8 normal pistons and 10 sticky pistons, and finally a lever as an input. For the ceiling version, you're gonna need, of course, some building blocks again, then 3 slabs, 22 redstone dust, 1 redstone torch, 12 redstone repeaters, 6 observers, 8 normal pistons, 10 sticky pistons and a lever. So overall, this is slightly less expensive when it comes especially to the observer count. But nevertheless, this is what you're gonna need, so let me quickly show you how to build those two block swappers. Okay, for the floor block swapper, we start with marking the area in the floor where the blocks will be pushed through, which is this ring here. The blocks themselves will end up in this position, essentially. Now from this ring on, first go 3 blocks down, and then in the center we need a 2x2 of double piston extenders, like this here, so essentially a 2x2x2 cube of sticky pistons. Then, towards the front, start with a 2x2 of lowered blocks here, 2 redstone wire and 2 repeaters on 4 ticks each, running into the bottom pistons. Then on top of those, we need observers running into full blocks on top of them. Quickly mirror this towards the back. Then connect front and back on the left side with a row of blocks here, last one needs to be raised, put redstone wire on top. Then on the right side add another raised block here, with some redstone wire on top. Then again at the front, on top of this redstone wire in the corner, place a full block. Then next to that an observer facing downwards, with a repeat on one tick in this direction, some redstone wire on top of this block. This will be our input, so let me put a block up here, with the lever there. So this is our input for now. When you connect this, make sure you don't accidentally power the line down there, so don't just put the lever directly on this block. Anyway, now let's go first a layer down with a block, put a repeater on 4 ticks on top. This runs into a full block on top of a sticky piston, then another block next to that, some redstone dust on top. Then we go down a layer and add 3 blocks here in a row. First we need a repeater on 4 ticks, then on 3 ticks, and then some redstone wire. Put 2 observers on top of the last 2, then 2 observers looking at them and running inwards into full blocks. Then we need a load block here with a repeater on 2 ticks running into a full block, which connects back to this line in the center. Now on the left side we do something somewhat similar. First we place a block here in front of the repeater, then a torch on the side of it, now a lowered block here, and then a full block here. And only then place your redstone wire here, so those two wires here are not connected. Then we need a block here with a repeater on 4 ticks, running into a sticky piston with a full block on top, then another block to the side of it, redstone dust on top. Now we go down a layer, have another 3 blocks here, place down a repeater on 2 ticks, 3 ticks, add some wire. Again, our two observers looking at the last two, then the observers inwards running into full blocks, then the load and raise block here, and in this gap our two tick repeater. That's the circuitry. Now for the normal piston, just place them going inwards on top of the four observers here. And that's the circuitry done. Now let's go and let's add a 2x2 of blocks in front of those pistons on the left side. And then let's add the blocks up here. And now all that's left is actually testing if it works. And that's looking good. So this is pretty much finished. Last part is filling in the floor and maybe putting some other blocks in there so you can actually see something happening. And voila, so as I can see, now the entire thing is completely finished up, which means now it's time to start talking about the ceiling version. Now for the ceiling version, we start again with marking the area where the blocks will be pushed through the ceiling, which is this ring here. The blocks themselves will end up in this position. Now from this ring, first go up three blocks, and in the middle place a 2x2 of double piston extenders, so essentially a 2x2x2 cube of sticky pistons like this here. Then towards the front and the back, we first start with observers next to the top pistons, followed by a row of two blocks, redstone wire here, and two repeaters on four ticks each there. Then below the observers we need full blocks. Same on this side here, so at the back we just mirror the setup, like so. Then at the front, on the right side of the middle, place one piece of redstone wire here. This is just there to update the butted pistons. So when those pistons are pushed downwards, they are in a butted state, and without this piece of redstone wire, they wouldn't notice that there is any power to them. So this is extremely important. Anyway, let's continue on. Next, we need an observer facing upwards in this corner here, followed by a full block, then two upside down steps, two full blocks, then on the right side, another two full blocks here, and one upside down step there. Put redstone dust on top of all these blocks, as you can see there. Then, below this observer, we need a block hovering below like this here, then a block to either side, some redstone wire here, and repeaters on each side on four ticks each. Then place a full block in front of this left repeater, some redstone dust on top, a sticky piston next to that, and a full block on top. Then towards the back, add first one block, then an observer powering downwards, and another full block, and around the corner another two full blocks. Now place two repeaters on four ticks each, like so, then some wire here, repeater on two ticks there, and some wire there, which should connect to this wire up there. Now on the right side, place a block in front of this repeater, with a torch to the side of it, then diagonal to that we need a block lowered, with a repeater on four ticks running into a sticky piston with a block on top. Then on this side we need a block next to the observer, then we go up a layer, add two blocks until we have three here, and then another two blocks around this corner, which should line up nicely with this upside down slab there. Then two redstone wire here, repeater on four ticks there, repeater on one tick there, and two redstone wire here and there. And now all that's left is adding in those pistons. So we start right below this nine here and just add the two double extenders there. And here we do the same. We start under this corner and go one in and place our double extender there. Now this here is our input. So just let's put a lever here for now. And now let's see. This is the side that will be powered first when we flick the lever, so on the left side, let's add our 2x2 of blocks here, and then the other set that's already placed in position here. And now let's test everything out, so just flick the lever. And that's looking good, and now let's look if the That also works perfect. So with that, the circuitry is done. So the last part is filling in the ceiling, obviously putting in something that is a bit more interesting to swap out, and maybe relocating the lever. And voila, so as you can see, now everything is finished up and works quite nicely. One thing to note here, when you are relocating the lever, for example, like I did here, just make sure that when you do that, the wire is not running into this area here, because otherwise, if you have a full block there and the wire is powered, this piston here will not retract. So this is the reason I've placed an additional lever up here, just to redirect this wire and not have it running into any problematic area. But besides of that, this is pretty much the end of this tutorial about those two block swappers. I hope you enjoyed it, and well, see ya!